It's Thursday, November the 19th, 2020. This is the date in the church calendar that is set aside for the commemoration of Elizabeth of Hungary. She was born in Hungary to a royal family in the 13th century. She was then married at age 14, young age, to a German who also was of royalty. She then took up residence in the Wartburg Castle, and it would make good sense, therefore, that it's in keeping with that that the Wartburg takes on significance, where Luther himself finds a bit of respite centuries later when he needs it. Well, she used the Wartburg as a place where she was always helping those who were in need. By the time she was 20, she was widowed. She then made arrangements for her children. She had three children to have their needs met, and she became a nun and gave herself to the care of others. And because she lived such an austere life, she ended up dying at a very young age of about 24. And because of her great reputation, everyone knew her for her acts of charity and service to others, denying her own needs for the sake of the benefit of others. She has been long revered and appreciated as a great example of charity towards others. Well, on this Thursday, we are focusing on the Gospel according to St. Luke. That is always our focus of late on Thursdays. And we're looking at Luke chapter 21, verses 29 to 33 right now. And you may recall the reason we're in Luke 21 is this is Luke's account of Jesus telling us about the end of the age. And so we're coming to the end of the church year. Gives us a good focus on all of time coming to an end as well. And so therefore, well, let's listen to what Jesus says. And the first thing he says here is, hey, look at the fig tree. You know when summer is coming because you can see the fig tree is going to blossom and such. So just as you can tell the season by what's going on with that fig tree, read the signs of the time as well. When you see the things that he's been talking about taking place, you know that the kingdom of God is near. Now, the rule and reign of God in Christ is already present, but it's about the consummation of that at the return of Christ. So he goes on then to say, with all those signs being ones that you can see happening at all times, and therefore you never know exactly when Christ is coming back, always waiting in anticipation, Jesus then goes on to say, truly, I am saying to you, this generation will not pass away until all has taken place. Now, what does he mean by this generation? Is he saying that the time frame, the people living at that time would not pass away until everything had happened? Well, obviously, he's not yet returned. And in Luke's account of the gospel, that phrase, this generation, is regularly used as a way to describe the whole of sinful humanity. So in other words, as long as sinful humanity is around, this generation, the sinful generation, well, these things will continue to take place. But once everything has taken place that Christ himself has promised is going to happen, then the sinful generation will come to an end. In other words, this is a great promise from Christ. The day is coming when sin will come to an end, and the righteous rule and reign of God in Christ will be seen in us, sin being dispelled, our sinful nature gone. Jesus even goes on to say, heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. The word of God stands forever. Now, when Jesus says this, he is even referencing his own word that he spoke centuries earlier through the prophet Isaiah, that the word of the Lord endures forever. This even became the motto of the Reformation. You will see it sometimes put this way, VDMA, which is an abbreviation of the Latin phrase Verbum Domini Manet in Aeternum, which means the word of the Lord stands forever. Now, it's interesting, God's word stands forever, including his word that talks about all of time is going to come to an end. So you could put it this way, that he has an unchanging word, and that unchanging word promises a changed creation. Heaven and earth will pass away, just like I am going to pass away. But what Christ also promises is that just as he came forth from the grave resurrected, I'm going to rise again. I will pass away and rise again, so will you. Same thing is also true for heaven and earth. Heaven and earth will pass away. All of this creation will be undone, but it will be remade. It will be resurrected, made whole, made perfect at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. And this is always the thrust with Christ's teaching about the end times. He's always pointing us forward to the end as something to be desired. Because right now we're stuck in the midst of the decay because of our fall into sin. Not only us, the whole creation. But the day is coming. We're set free from that. So his unchanging word promises a changed creation, a creation that is going to be made whole and perfect, all because Christ has died and risen again for us. Let us pray. Lord God, in the midst of this dying creation, give us sure confidence that we will all rise to life everlasting. And not only our own bodies, but even the heavens and the earth, this creation will be made whole and complete. Until that day, O Lord, grant us steadfastness and fill us with compassion and kindness towards others, just like Elizabeth of Hungary. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.